Thank you. That this is the MS1 band, and that particular piece is called Samba de Soleil, which is basically a samba piece, Carnival of the Sun, Festival of the Sun. It's meant to be played around carnival time, like Mardi Gras. But it's a fun song. We thought it'd be a great opening piece. It gets to feature the percussion doing all kinds of wood blocks and so forth. And it's just a fun piece. We just enjoyed playing it. We thought it'd be a good opener for us. The next piece we're going to play is an old classic from the 1960s, Barbara Ann from, the Beach Boys. Yeah, so it's exactly what you would think it is. And it kind of proves that these students can get busy and have some fun. This is not a particularly large group, but they've got a really full sound. So sit back and enjoy our brand.
Thank you.
last on our list is an oldie but a goodie, Feliz Navidad. Hope you're feeling the season. We need some snow. It's time. So, you know, we're doing our part. The band did its part on Monday night at the high school, and we're doing our part. So, you know, let's bring it over. I hear like if you like sleep with a spoon under your pillow or something like that, that brings about snow. If you're into that sort of thing, I don't know. I'm not superstitious at all. Anyway, Feliz Navidad. And after this band plays, they're gonna step off, and the orchestra is gonna come on. So just to let you know, thank you so much. You've been a very lovely audience so far. Thank you.
Hello, everybody. Welcome, welcome. It's such an honor to be back here. It's such a pleasure. I am Michael Obert, Mr. Obert. I'm director of the orchestras here at LILA. And for a hot minute, I was director of the choirs as well. But we've got a new choir teacher. You met him not too long ago, Mr. Steven, and we're extremely excited to have him here. And what a great job he's been doing with the choirs. That first one that we played was Velocity by Brian Bollinges. That one's really tricky. That one's tough for us. But the kids here were up for the challenge. I think they did a great job just now. That was a good challenge. Coming up next, we've got a fun, kind of jazzy tune. It's called Strawberry Jam Session. And we've got my dear friend here, Mr. Runke, playing the bass for us. All right, let's hit it. Just 2 years ago. Raise your hand if you were in the beginning orchestra 2 years ago. Yeah, that's a good number. Raise your hand if you were in the beginning orchestra last year. Yeah, let's go, Emma. Alright, so yeah, we've got the Kings and St. Nick. It's a fun arrangement of three tunes I hope you recognize.
Thank you.
one more for you. Sailor song. This one is super fun. It's fast, exciting, energetic. And the kids just love to play. Raise your hand if you love to play this one. Yeah! All right, let's do it.
I love opening up band pieces, band concerts with marches, and originally was actually going to start with a different number, and actually one of the very few times I made a change very close to the concert date, ended up putting this first because, let's do the march in the beginning. So while I wasn't originally going to start it with this one, it works really good as an opener. This group is a little smaller than MS1. These are mostly eighth graders, and we're, while we don't have all the sections that the other ones do, we have no clarinets, for example. We also do not have any oboes, and we don't have any French horns. What we do have is a lot of moxie and a lot of technical ability, and these students here have been working really, really hard on some rather technical, challenging pieces. And I think you'll enjoy listening to them. The nice thing about this is that you can really hear the detail work in what they're doing. So it's kind of flex band arrangement sort of thing. So there's a lot of bands, because of the COVID situation, have had to convert to flex band music, where you're using different arrangements of music other than you would normally. And that's kind of what we're doing with this band. So the first piece is pretty self-explanatory. The next one, Dance of the Reed Pipes, is from the Nutcracker Suite by Peter Ilyich Tchaikovsky. And this one is, it definitely features the flutes. Well, with this band, it features everyone. There's nobody who just kind of sits out on this. But everyone's got some detail work that they have to do, and you'll notice the percussion. They don't get to do the snare drums or the bass on this. So you're going to notice things like the bells, and you're going to notice a bass being played, and that's back there by Devin, one of our percussionists, who's also a very fine keyboard player. Turns out, keyboard players and percussion, they match really well. So if you want to be a good percussionist, a good drummer, be good at the piano. That really seems to be a good side thing to be aware of. Everyone's got something on this one, and I hope that you enjoy this. This is a lot of fun to play. Dance of the Reed Pipes.
Thank you.
trumpets. You probably noticed kind of a little, like almost a toy trumpet sound back there. With that piece, both of our trumpet players went out and got mutes. I'm wondering if you wouldn't mind just holding them up. Yeah, so you can see it. They're straight mutes. It's hard to see. These ones are black, but they're really cool. They kind of changed the sound of the trumpet for that to give it that kind of toy. What is the Nutcracker Suite all about? It's those toys and so forth. So it creates that real nice sound. And they each took a solo. So Caden took a solo and Natalie took a solo. So, and it, obviously the flutes had a big part of that. Our next piece, I don't know who it features more of, but I'm going to put a plug for the timpani back there, Matt Diener on the timpani. So this piece is called Coventry Carol, and it is associated with Christmas and the holiday spirit. There's a story behind it and on how it was written. This particular version is a fantasia, so you've heard this theme done many, many times. It goes back many, many hundreds of years. This is put together in kind of a fantasy version of it, and with some really interesting percussion tracks that go with it. So, the Coventry Carol Fantasia. One of the reasons I step out of the way when I after playing, because I figured that's your best chance to get a picture of them. You probably want to take a picture. Well, what I don't want you doing is running up and taking a picture while I'm conducting. So I figured the least I can do is get out of the way so you can snap a picture of them when they're done singing, or done playing in this case. And I figured that was probably the best thing to do. So that's my the motive behind it. I also want to thank our percussion back there. Devin O'Donnell has been doing the snares very artfully. And we get another drummer from the other band who's given a little extra hand with our last song. But before we do that, I really want to say some words of thanks. There are so many people to thank. Special thanks to Tristan Ray back there operating the lights and sound. He's been doing a fantastic job. He's giving a little wave back there. He has done an enormous job. He's been super helpful. He helped the high school band the other day. He came early, stayed late, got everything set up, did the microphones. He's been doing checks before and after. All week long, he's been coming in and making adjustments. Really, he's done a fantastic job. And also Paul Peterson from LATV. It's being streamed because of other people. This is far beyond any technical skill I have. I have no idea how to do that. Also, thanks to Kathy Bystrom and Jesse Reck. Reek, I'm not sure exactly how to pronounce that, her name, for getting the programs out. And these programs are even in color, which is a pretty nice touch. And the promotion for it, I'm very, very grateful. Thanks to Kat Schwartz for watching students while the groups are performing. Also thanks to my colleagues, Mr. Obert and Mr. Orgidos, who are really great to work with, and administration for giving us the flexibility and the support needed to make this work. And also the donors, and especially you guys. I want to thank you for following COVID protocols and trying to be respectful of not overcrowding the auditorium this evening. It was a concern of ours, and I'm just really grateful that you guys were real respectful and tasteful about it, and looking out, I just have a really good feeling about it, the spirit of cooperation, and the fact that this is being live streamed and so it can be viewed later is really nice. So thank you to everybody. Our last piece, we want to send you out with a smile on your face, and that's really, really the main goal here. Little Winter Wonderland.